The typical parts list should include the A. part number, B. manufacturing material, C. number of parts needed, D. all of the above. The correct answer is all of the above. A typical set of mechanical working drawings includes A. exploded assembly, B. part details, C. parts list, D. all of the above. The correct answer is all of the above. The title block used on working drawings should include the A. sheet number, B. line type, C. layer set, D. all of the above. The correct answer is sheet number. One critical issue drafters need to pay close attention to is the A. size of the sheet, B. designer's intent, C. scale factor, D. none of the above. The correct answer is designer's intent. In the mechanical design process, the first step is to A. brainstorm solutions, B. prepare rough sketches, C. prepare a budget, D. identify the problem. The correct answer is identify the problem. The text used on a typical detail sheet should be A. placed horizontally, B. in bold text, C. in an architectural text style, D. none of the above. The correct answer is placed horizontally. In an exploded assembly drawing, it is customary for the drafter to use a line to illustrate how parts fit together. A. phantom, B. hidden, C. dashed, D. center. The correct answer is phantom. It is customary for the first sheet of a working drawing set to include A. a parts list, B. exploded assembly, C. assembled assembly, D. all of the above. The correct answer is all of the above. In order to create an accurate assembly drawing, the drafter should create the drawings first. A. detail, B. title block, C. parts list, D. isometric. The correct answer is detail. The thread note for a typical bolt will include the A. major diameter of the thread, B. material, C. center line, D. offset distance. The correct answer is major diameter of the thread.